So in this video, I'm gonna talk about the best of Santa Marta. In the distance, you can see Rodadero. It's probably the preferred destination for national tourists. You can get a boat from there for about $15. It'll take you to the aquarium on the other side of this point.
Francis Drake se devuelve otra vez. Cuando estaba entrando el galeón a la bahía de Gaira, que es el Rodadero, cayó la tormenta, se mojó la pólvora, se apagaron los arcabuces y ganaron a punta de flecha los Gaira. Batalla de Gaira 1596.
And then you can zip line straight down here into Playa Blanca, one of the nicer beaches here in Santa Marta. So right over here you can see the Centro Histórico of Santa Marta, and over the ridge is Taganga. So because I like locations with history and color and local flavor, I'm gonna talk about Santa Marta from the perspective of staying in the Centro Histórico. It's about time I gave some attention to Santa Marta. It's the gateway to so many different activities. You've got Tayrona National Park. That's where the cover of The Lonely Planet usually comes from. Beyond Minca, you've got bird watching, jungle, eco retreats. You've got indigenous that still inhabit the area, and you've got snow-capped Sierra Nevada mountain ranges. You've got Palomino, and then there's the Lost City Trek, which is a trek through the jungle to a lost indigenous city. And then beyond that, you've got a flamingo reserve, Riohacha, Cabo de la Vela, Punta Gallinas. This place is unreal, and Santa Marta is the comfortable base camp to experience all of that coastline to the east. Most of the national tourism seems to still be around Santa Marta and Tayrona National Park, but the gringo trail is certainly already in Palomino. I think over the next 5 or 10 years, we're gonna see that extend to Riohacha and Cabo de la Vela. Okay, so I'm only here for a couple days, but I do wanna show you the best of Santa Marta. So let's get into it, and let's start with an epic drone shot. So I found myself a delicious seafood soup and a fresh pineapple juice for about 10,000 pesos. But if you're not into street food, there's a lot of restaurants with a lot of indigenous and European flavor influences. Santa Marta is located in the department of Magdalena, which also happens to be the same department that Gabriel Garcia Marquez was born in, the Nobel-winning author and the creator of magical realism.
He's a pretty big deal around here, and they named the library after him.
There's some fascinating history here in Santa Marta as well. Make sure to check out the Museo de Oro Tayrona. It seems in the Centro Histórico, there's not as many limitations architecturally. So it seems like people are getting a bit more creative with the restoration and the colors on the walls. So in terms of architecture and the people living in the Centro Histórico here in Santa Marta, I see elements of both Getsemani and the old city of Cartagena. But here it seems to have fused together, it seems to have blended together a bit more, maybe because there isn't a wall. And here in Parque de los Novios, there's a bunch of new restaurants and bars coming in. It looks like it's becoming a really important social hub of the city. It's shady, it's breezy, and a great place to catch a happy hour cocktail special.
Santa Marta, Barranquilla y Cartagena son tres perlas que brotaron en la arena. Tres estrellas del mar Caribe que descansan en la orilla de la playa. En el bello amanecer de su bahía se refleja en Santa Marta su alegría, su nostalgia, su historia, su hidalguía, su leyenda de amor, su melodía. Tú sabes que los correo, estamos en Santa Marta, el callejón del correo. Porque yo improviso, tú sabes que este es otro. El callejón del correo y el parque de los novios. Porque yo improviso, yo siempre lo hago el día. La rica, deliciosa comida, la mozzarella.
I'm eating tonight at La Mozzarella. This is Calleye, a really traditional dish here in Santa Marta. It's got green banana, cheese, and a bit of meat. It's super traditional here. Let's get into it. Oh my God. I have no idea why this dish is not more famous than it is. I think El Calleye just became my favorite Colombian dish. Half the fun of traveling is trying new restaurants, but if you'd like some recommendations, I would check out Auso, Donde Chucho, La Mart, Rocoto, Republica de Manzanares, and try some El Calleye. I just got my mind blown. Alright, so in the corner of Parque de los Novios, I found a pretty healthy restaurant. They've got kombucha, they've got a whole bunch of vegan options. So Santa Marta is a resting place for tourists who are coming through. So from Thursday to Sunday, you're gonna see it gets a bit more lively. Any other day of the week, you can come on down to a place like this, fairly casual, open air. You've got the ocean breeze, very affordable drinks, a good way to pass a quiet evening.
He vivido toda mi vida aquí. La amo como si, bueno, la llevo en mi sangre, en mi piel.
¿Dónde está la rumba hoy en día?
La rumba, en la puerta.
Ajá.
La puerta o la bodeguita pirata, lo máximo, para ¿sí? bailar.
Ajá. ¿Y todos los días o en los fines de semana? ¿Como desde jueves hasta el domingo
o cuándo? La puerta jueves, viernes y sábado.
Sí.
Pero la bodeguita está abierta todos los días.
Las caleñas son como las flores.
First time I'm getting in the water on this trip.
been doing other stuff, as you've seen. So the beach in downtown Santa Marta, it's pretty calm. Just like Cartagena, you do have to get a boat to some of the best beaches. If you're looking for those next level beaches, I would recommend Playa Arrecifes, Playa Cristal, Playa Concho, and of course Playa Grande and Playa Blanca, which are a bit closer. I'm gonna leave it at that. I hope I've explained why tourism in Santa Marta is growing as much as it is. What I would really like to tell you guys about is a renovation and rental project that we're looking at right here in Centro Santa Marta. So if you want more details, you're gonna have to click like, click subscribe. In the meantime, I invite you guys to embrace your fears. My name is Sam Miller. I'm part of a group of real estate entrepreneurs that are creating turnkey investments as well as taking the Airbnb experience to the next level. It means we turn properties like this into properties like this. It's going to be a wild ride. Click the like button on Facebook, subscribe on YouTube.
Like and subscribe.
Yeah.